Hello everyone and welcome to our channel. In today's video tutorial, I will show you how to make this Alpine Christmas stocking. It's very textured, but it's really easy to make. It's just three rows repeat. Two of the rows are basic stitches as half double crochet and double crochet, but this textured part here is made with front post double crochets. I will show you how to make it as we crochet along in the video. For this stocking, I used Bernat Premium worsted weight yarn. It is for medium weight yarn. For the sample here, I used cream color, which is Aran color, and this is the color Pine of Bernat Premium. But for the video tutorial, I will use red and this Cafe au Lait. I don't know how to pronounce it. But it's light brown or cappuccino color. It will be more easier and more visible for the video when I show you the stitches. So let's start with the materials. As I said, we will need worsted weight yarn, measuring tape. If you want to see the final measurements of your stocking, it's not necessary in need. We will need 6 mm crochet hook, a pair of scissors. We will need a needle with a bigger loop, and we will need a few stitch markers. Now let's start with the pattern, but first I will show you the final measurements of the socks of the stocking. When we measure it from the heel through the toes, it's 27 centimeters, and the length of the stocking is 40 centimeters. This is if you use similar yarn and the same hook as mine. So let's start with the pattern. We will start. I will make the stocking red, and this part, the toes, the heel and the rib here, I will make it with the brown color. So let's start. Take your brown color and your hook. Start with magic ring. I will show you how to make the magic ring. Wrap the yarn around your fingers twice, like this. Then insert your hook from the under the first wrap here and pull the second through the first, like this. Then just make chain one. Now take the loop from your fingers. As you can see, we have the magic ring done. It is better as you can when we finish the round, when we close the ring, there will be no hole in the magic ring. So we will start with making double crochet. Make 12 double crochet into the ring. So how we will make it? Yarn over, insert your hook into the ring, yarn over, pull through the ring. We have 3 loops on our hook. Yarn over and pull through the first 2 loops on your hook. Now we have 2 loops on our hook. Yarn over again and pull through the remaining 2 loops. This is how we make the double crochet. I will show you one more time. Yarn over, insert your hook into the ring. Yarn over and pull through the ring. We have 3 loops on our hook. Yarn over, pull through the 2 loops on your hook. Now we have 2 loops left on our hook. Yarn over and pull through the remaining 2 loops on your hook. Now we will make 12 double crochet. I have made 2. Now I will make the rest 10 double crochets. 3 have 12 double crochet. Now close the ring. And we will join with slip stitch on top of our first stitch. Now round 2, chain 3. This is counted as double crochet, and now make double crochet into the base of initial chain 3 here. We will decrease in this round and we will make 2 double crochet into each stitch around, so in the end of the row, in the end of the round, we will have 24 stitches. So make 2 double crochet into the same stitch. 1 double crochet, 2 double crochet. This is the increase. We will repeat this till the end of the round. Like this. Just make 2 double crochet till the end. I finished my second round. As you can see, we made 2 double crochet into each stitch. Now join with slip stitch into the third chain of our initial chain 3. 1, 2, 3. Round 3. Chain 3 again. This is counted as double crochet. Now make 2 double crochet into the next stitch. Now we will repeat this till the end of the round. We will make double crochet into the next stitch and we will increase into the second stitch. I'm making double crochet in the next stitch and now I will make 2 double crochet into the second stitch. 1 double crochet, 2 double crochet. This is the pattern that we will repeat till the end of the round. So we are making double crochet into the next stitch and 2 double crochet into the second stitch. Repeat this till the end of the round 3. Let me finish my round 3 and see you in round 4. I have finished my round 3. Now I will join with slip stitch into the third chain of initial chain 3. 1, 2, 3 here. In round 4, we will stop increasing and now we will just make double crochet into each stitch till the end of the round. So chain 3, this is counted as double crochet, and now make double crochet into each stitch till the end of the round. We will stop increasing and we will just continue with the stitches that we have. In the end of round 1 we have 12 stitches, in round 2 we have 24 stitches and in round 3 we have 36 stitches. In round 4 as well we have 36 stitches. So make double crochet into each stitch till the end of the round. And join with slip stitch into the third chain of initial chain 3 again. Let me finish my round 4 and see you in round 5. I have finished my fourth round and now we will start with the sole of the socks, of the stocking. So we will switch to our main color. For me it's red. Now attach the red color. Secure it with slip knot, with a knot. Now we will start with round 5. In round 5, chain 1 and we will make single crochet into each stitch across around. Chain 1, make single crochet into the base of initial chain 1. Now make single crochet into each stitch around. Just insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through the stitch. We have 2 loops on our hook. Yarn over one more time and pull through the both loop on your hook. This is how we make the single crochet. Insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through the stitch, yarn over and pull through the 2 loops on your hook. Now just repeat this till the end of the round. We are making single crochet into each stitch around. I have finished my fifth round and now we will join with slip stitch on top of our first stitch. Round 6. In round 6 we will make double crochet into each stitch till the end of the round, so chain 3 and make double crochet into each stitch around. 1 double crochet, 2, 3, 4. Repeat this till the end. Just make double crochet into each stitch around. Join with slip stitch into the third chain of initial chain 3. Let me finish my round and see you in round 7. I have finished my round 6. Now I will show you round 7, which is this textured round. In this round we will make front post double crochet. So chain 3, this is counted as double crochet. Now we will make front post double crochet 2 together. It's front post cluster. How we will make it? Yarn over, then insert your hook from front to back and from back to front around the post of your double crochet. Yarn over again and pull through around the post of your double crochet. We have 3 loops on our hook. Yarn over and pull through only the 2 loops on your hook. This is the first front post double crochet, but we are making a cluster of them, so we will make 2 front post double crochet together. Yarn over, insert your hook again from front to back and back to front around the post like this. Yarn over and pull it through around the post. We have 4 loops. Yarn over and pull through the first 2 loops on your hook. Now we have 3 loops on our hook. Yarn over and pull through the 3 loops on your hook. This is the front post double crochet cluster. Then we will make double crochet into the next stitch. Now again we will make front post double crochet cluster. I will show you one more time. Yarn over, insert your hook from front to back and back to front around the post like this. Yarn over and pull around the post. We have 3 loops on our hook. Yarn over and pull through the 2 loops on your hook. Now we have made our first front post double crochet. Yarn over again and insert it the same as we did in the first, from around the post of your double crochet. Yarn over and pull it through around the post. Now we have 4 loops on our hook. Yarn over and pull through only the first 2 loops on your hook. We have made the cluster and just close it. Yarn over and pull through the 3 loops on your hook. This is the second front post double crochet cluster. Then make double crochet into the next stitch. Repeat this till the end of the round. So we will make front post double crochet cluster into the next stitch and double crochet into the second stitch. I will show you one more time. The first front post double crochet and this is the second one. Work them together. This is the cluster and make double crochet into the next stitch. This is how it will look when we finish the round. Repeat this till the end. Now let me finish my round 7 and see you in round 8. Now start with round 8. In round 8 we will make half double crochet stitch in every stitch around. So chain 2. This is counted as half double crochet stitch. And now make half double crochet into each stitch around. Yarn over, insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over and pull through the stitch. We have 3 loops on our hook. Yarn over again and pull through all the loops on your hook. This is how we will make half double crochet stitch. I'm showing you one more time. Yarn over, insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over again and pull through the stitch. We have 3 loops on our hook. Yarn over and pull through all the loops on your hook. Now repeat this till the end of your round. Make half double crochet stitch in every stitch till the end of round 8. Finished my round 8. Join with slip stitch into the second chain, 1, 2, into the second chain of our initial chain 2. This is how it will look. Now we will start with round 9. In round 9, we will work in the third loop of our half double crochet stitch that we have made in the previous round 8. I will show you how, and even I will show you with different color so it will be easier for you to see. I will take the brown color again, only just for this round, so it will be easier for you to see. Now, as you can see here, we have the regular V-stitch of our stitch. This is the front loop and this is the back loop. But when you turn a little bit your work, you can see that here at the back we have another loop. This is the third loop of our half double crochet. We will work into this loop here. This is the third loop of the half double crochet. So we will make double crochet, as I said. Now chain 3. And we will work into the third loop of the half double crochet. Make double crochet into each stitch till the end of the round, but only work into the third loop of this half double crochet. We will work here. This is how it will look. As you can see, we have a little rib here. This is because we are working into the third loop of our half double crochet that we have made in the previous round. Repeat this till the end of the round. Now I will switch back to red and make it with red. Let me finish my round 9 and see you in round 10. I finished my round 9. As you can see, this is the rib. Now join with slip stitch into the third chain of initial chain 3. 1, 2, 3 here. Now we will just continue by repeating round 7, 8 and 9, alternating them. You need to repeat this 3 more times. So till you reach the heel, you need to repeat row 7, 8, 9. 3 more times. So chain 3, I am now round 10 is the same as round 7. So we will make the front post double crochet cluster stitch. Chain 3, this is counted as double crochet. Now just make the front post double crochet cluster into the next stitch. Then again, just make double crochet into the next stitch and make cluster front post double crochet into the next stitch and make double crochet into the next stitch. Then in round 11 we will make half double crochet round. It's the same as this here. Then in round 12 we will make double crochet into the third chain, into the third loop of our half double crochet stitch. Repeat this 3 more times, as I said. In the we will reach till here, till the heel. As you can see, we will have 4 repeats of round 7, 8, 9. Here is round 7, 8, 9, and just repeat this for 3 more times and we will reach the heel part. So let me finish my repeats and see you in the making the heel. I have finished my 18th round. As I said, we have 4 repeats of round 7, 8 and 9 in the end. Now we will start by making the heel. But before we start the heel, take a stitch marker and put it in the 2 stitches before the start of the row. So this is the stitch before the last stitch. Put the stitch marker there. We will need it when we start to make the length of the stocking. Now switch to the color of your heel. I will switch to brown color. Cut the red color. Now we will start by making the heel. This part. Chain 3. It's counted as double crochet. And now make double crochet into the next 15 stitches. One double crochet, 2, 3. This is counted as double crochet, so in the end we will have 16 double crochet. Now we will make row 2 of our heel, chain 3. It is counted as double crochet again. Turn your work and now make double crochet into each stitch till the end. We are skipping the very first stitch as the chain 3 is counted as double crochet. Make double crochet into the next stitch. 1 When you reach the end of the row, the last stitch is our turning chain. This is the initial chain 3 of the previous row. Make double crochet into the third chain of the turning chain 3. Row 3 is the same as row 2, chain 3. Turn your work and make double crochet into each stitch till the end and make double crochet into the third chain of your turning chain 3. Let me finish row 3 of the heel and see you in row 4. Row 4 is the same again. I forgot to tell you. But chain 3 and make double crochet into each stitch till the end of the row and make double crochet into the third chain of your turning chain. I finished my fourth row of the heel. Now I will start, we will start row 5 and we will start forming the heel now. So chain 3 and now turn your work and make double crochet into the next 3 stitches. 1 double crochet, 2 double crochet, 3 double crochet. Now make half double crochet into the next 8 stitches. 1 half double crochet, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 half double crochet, 7 and 8. We have 3 stitches remaining in the turning chain. Make double crochet into these stitches. So double crochet, 3 double crochet And now double crochet into the turning chain. Then chain 2, turn your work. This is row 6. Chain 2, turn your work and make half double crochet into the next 3 stitches. 1 half double crochet, 2 half double crochet, 3 half double crochet. Now we will decrease. We will make single crochet 2 together 4 times. How we will make it? Insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through the loop, pull through the stitch, and now again insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over and pull through. We have 3 loops on our hook. Yarn over and pull through all the loops on your hook. This is how we make single crochet 2 together. This is the single crochet decrease. We will repeat this 4 times. Insert into the first stitch, yarn over, pull through, insert into the second stitch, yarn over, pull through the stitch. We have 3 loops on our hook. Yarn over and pull through all the loops on your hook. Repeat this 2 more times. So we have 4 decrease. And now make half double crochet into the remaining stitches. 1 half double crochet, 2 half double crochet, 3 half double crochet, and make half double crochet into the third chain of your turning chain 3. This is how it will look, and in the end we will close the heel like this. I will show you how to close the heel. Now I will show you how to close the heel. Fold your heel like this. Turn your work. Grab your stitch, chain 1. And turn your work. Now insert your hook into the first chain of the initial chain here, and then into the first stitch of the other side. Now yarn over and pull through the loop and pull through the loop on your hook. We will join with slip stitch, and then insert your hook into the next stitch of the first side, and then into the second stitch of the second side, and just make a slip stitch. Repeat this till we will close the whole heel. This is how it looks, and this is from the right side of your work. This is how it will look when it's closed. Now we will start with the upper part of the stocking. We have put the stitch marker 2 stitches before the 1 stitch before the last one, but we'll move it 1 more here. So it will be the 3rd stitch before the end. Insert your hook into the 3 stitches before the end of the last row, 18th row of the sole. Join the color and now chain 1 and make single crochet into the same stitch. Now we will make the decrease. We will make single crochet 3 together. The first single crochet, the first single crochet is made into the next stitch, then into the second stitch here, and the 3rd single crochet will be made into this chain space, and we will work them all together. So this is the first single crochet, the second one, and this is the third one. We are not finishing the single crochet, as we will make the decrease and we will finish them all together. This is the single crochet, three together, decrease. Now make two single crochet into the next space here around the post of this stitch. Two single crochet, then make two single crochet into the next space. In all double crochet rows, we will make two single crochet in around the post of the first or last stitch of the double crochet row. This is the posts. And when we reach the half double crochet row here, we will make one single crochet. It will be like this. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 rows of double crochet, so we have 8 single crochet, 2 single crochet in each row, and then in the half double crochet we have 1 single crochet. The first row of double crochet is for the decrease, and continue, make 1 single crochet into the half double crochet row, then make 2 single crochet into the next 4. 2, 3, 4. And now we will make the second decrease, as and again we have the first single crochet of the single crochet three together. The first single crochet we will make here, and then the next into the next two stitches. The first single crochet, the second single crochet, and this is the third single crochet. Work them together. Now just make single crochet into each stitch till the end of the round. Into the on top of the first stitch. In the end of this round, we will have 36 stitches. Now we will continue to make the upper part. So chain 3 and make double crochet into the next stitch. This double crochet is counted as a stitch, and make double crochet into each stitch till the end of the round. It will be the same as the sole of the stocking. As you can see, this is the same. We will just repeat round 7, 8 and 9. I will show you. Let me finish my double crochet round and see you in next round. As I said, in the sole we have 18 rounds. The single crochet round is the 19th, and this is the 20th. Round 20. So let's start with round 21. We will start this pattern again, and so round 20 is the same as round 7, the front post double crochet cluster round. So chain 3 and make front post double crochet cluster into the next stitch, then double crochet into the next stitch. The front post double cluster is two front post double crochet together. The first front post, the second, work them together and make double crochet into the next stitch. We will repeat this till the end of the round. Front post double crochet cluster and double crochet into the next stitch. Now we will repeat this. As I said, the upper part of the stocking is made the same as the sole of the stocking. So repeat the repeat round 7, 8 and 9 4 times as we did here. We have one row of one round of front post double crochet two together cluster. Then we have half double crochet round, and the third round that we need to repeat is double crochet into the third loop of your half double crochet we made in the previous row, in the previous round. Let me finish my repeats. You need to have four repeats. This is the fourth repeat, the first repeat, second, the third repeat, and this is the fourth repeat. You will finish with double crochet. This is the double crochet of the fourth repeat. Let me finish my repeats and see you when we start making the brimming of the brim of the stocking. As I said, I finished my four repeats of round 7, 8 and 9. These are the four repeats. We are finishing with round 9, which is the double crochet round. And now we reached this part of the stocking. So as you can see, this is the double crochet round. This is round 9, the last repeat of round 9, and now we will make two rounds of only double crochet. As when we make the brim, we will fold the brim and it will cover the double crochet rows rounds. So let's start with the last two rounds before we start the brim of the sock of the stocking. Chain 3 and just make double crochet into each stitch till the end of the round. Repeat this for the next round as well. So we will make two rounds of double crochet into each stitch till the end of the round, and we will join with slip stitch into the third chain of initial chain 3. Let me finish my last two rounds before we start the brim, and I will show you how to make the brim. I have finished my last two rounds of double crochet. Now switch, join with slip stitch into the third chain of initial chain 3 and switch to your rib, heel and toes color. For me, as I said, it's the brown color. Cut the red color. Now we will start with the brim. The brim is worked in rows like this. And when we go one way around till the end and back, we will join the row with slip stitch to the stocking. So let's start. So we will start with chain 10 by chaining 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We have chain 10. Now make single crochet into the second chain from your hook. 1, 2. We have chain 10. Now we will make single crochet into the second chain from your hook. 1, 2. And now continue making single crochet into the remaining chains. 1 single crochet, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We have 9 stitches. Now we will attach this row to the stocking itself. So skip one stitch here, as this row is counted for this stitch here. Now skip this stitch and slip stitch into the next stitch. Like this. Now turn your work and we will work in the back loop only. This is the front loop and this is the back loop of our row. So make single crochet into the back loop of each stitch. The whole brim is worked only into the back loop of the stitch. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now again chain 1, turn your work again and just repeat the same. Single crochet into the back loop only. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now, as we have two rows here, we will skip one stitch and we will make slip stitch into the next stitch. And again, just continue, make single crochet into each stitch in the back loop only. We are working only into the back loop. Chain 1, turn your work and just repeat the same. Make single crochet into each stitch in the back loop only. When we reach the stocking row here, skip one stitch and make slip stitch into the next stitch. This is how it will look. Continue this till the end of the till you reach the end, and I will show you how to join both sides. So it will be finished like this. This part here is the joining part. Now let me finish my brim and see you in the joining part. I nearly finished my brim. So I reached the end of my brim. As you can see, we have two stitches left here. We will skip the next first stitch and we will make slip stitch into the next stitch. And now we will make two more rows. So I will make them single crochet into the back loop. And then we will join both sides. This is the last row. I finished my last row, slip stitch into the first stitch here that we have made the first chain, foundation chain. Now we will join both sides. You don't need to fold it, as this will be the wrong side when we fold it like this. Chain 1. And now insert your hook into the first stitch of one side and then into the back loop of the other side and join with slip stitch. insert into the first, into the stitch of the first side, then into the back loop of the second side, and just join with slip stitch. Fasten off. And this is the end result. Now I will fold it. And this is how it will look in the end. Now I will show you how to make the attachment piece here. I don't know how it's called. The English is not my mother language, so sometimes I have difficulties with some parts of the garments. Now, the hanger part. For this we will make a chain 17. We will start with foundation chain of 17. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. We have foundation chain of 17. Or let's make them 17, 18, 19, 20. Foundation chain of 20. Fold it and you will see how the length, if it's okay for you. If you wanted to make it bigger or smaller, just adjust the foundation chains. Now we will make half double crochet into the third chain from your hook. 1, 2, 3. This is the third chain. And continue making half double crochet in each chain till the end. Like this. Fasten off, leave a longer tail for sewing. Now take your needle. First I will weave the ends in. Fold it like this to two and then just sew it onto the sock. It depends on you how you want it to point, the toes to point to left or right. It doesn't matter for the hanger. Just sew it on the back part, which is the heel part here, not here, here. Thank you. And your stocking is done. If you liked, I hope you liked the video. If you liked the video, please subscribe to our channel and press the bell button. So whenever we have a new video, you will be notified. Here is the two colors that I have made. You can always choose your colors. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.